six employees, one of whom was the current director of this now very large organization. But we had six in the beginning, one of whom was Ray. We were in this little tiny two-story office building in Middlebury, on the turnpike in Middlebury. And we quickly managed to move to New Britain on Russell Street in an old Victorian house, and ultimately rented the house across the street also, so that we were able to expand our services. And I saw our mission as twofold at that time. One, that to continue as an entity, one, we needed to provide some services ourselves. And two, that we needed to begin to provide more coordination of care for the individuals within the service system. We were building services, we were advocating at the legislature for funding, and so it was kind of an exciting time, a lobbying time, a time of advocacy, a time of building services.
The most important thing was to find and develop services that were responsive to the people who needed the services. There were a number of needs assessments that were conducted over the years, and the affiliates became the lead agency who tried to develop programs that addressed those needs. They worked closely with the Regional Mental Health Board and worked closely with the state agency to provide those services, and were seen at that time, as they are now, as an agency that knew what the priorities needed to be and responded to those priorities. I think the most important thing about the affiliates then and now is that they understood that we're in the business of helping people, and they put the people first.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy.
CMHA was right on the cutting edge in terms of helping the state develop mechanisms and effective supportive community settings for people that had been long-term institutionalized, and that really without the kind of help and support for CMHA would still be in a hospital. And I found that to be inspiring, and it was a very exciting time to be working there, because that model was something that helped us build our children's service. Places like CMHA over decades have shown that there is hope, and that they are a compassionate oasis from the outside world that can be uncontrollable and uncaring. And I think it is a safe base for a lot of people who have needed that level of support to come back into their community and to feel like this can be a home for them, and that they can be productive, they can work and live healthy lives. And I think that has always remained. That was the core of what I think was transpiring at CMHA 20 years ago when I was involved in. And I think from all of my observation, it remains a consistent theme.
It's been quite an evolution for CMHA, which is one of our flagship organizations. CMHA obviously is one of our local mental health authorities. We take that very seriously. Our local mental health authorities are the lead entities that run and manage our mental health system for us. And so almost 20 years ago, if we were having a chat, we would be talking about how to bring together substance abuse and mental health. Well, we did that. And the contract relationships or entities running their own services have brought those two aspects of the service system together. And CMHA was at the forefront of those. And CMHA is and continues to evolve as a very, very client-focused organization. You know, at the vanguard of providing services in the community, keeping people out of the hospitals, getting people out of the hospitals, and helping them on their road to recovery.
So I think, you know, in 1999, 2000, the Department of Mental Health really focused on trying to sort of change the language and the landscape and talk more about recovery. And we relied on local mental health authorities to help us with that, to help bring people out into the community, out of the hospital setting. And CMHA played a role in that in terms of being very involved as we moved hundreds of people actually out of CVH and back into the community, some who had been there for many, many years. And CMHA was always willing to step up to the plate, help us put together some very involved, often discharge plans and treatment plans for people in the community. And we're very open to the idea of at times taking what looked like risk, which fortunately seemed to always work out very positively. And again, I think it was the interactions with staff that genuinely were attached to patients and genuinely wanted them to succeed in the community. That was a huge help for us, and I think that continues as we speak today.
Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy.
Well, I just want to wish CMHA happy 40th anniversary, and I'm very proud to have been a part of the beginning.
Congratulations to CMHA on its 40th anniversary. It's a big anniversary. You've done wonderful work for years and years, and I'm sure it will continue, but reaching a 40-year milestone is no small feat in these days when money's tight and trying to make things work is not always easy. So congratulations to all of you on reaching this very important milestone.
I hope that CMHA has another 40 years of the wonderful work that it's done, because it's a blessing for the community. And I think that it's incredibly important that places like CMHA remain as these places of oasis, like I said, of hope in an outside world that can be chaotic. We need that consistency. Everybody needs to feel like they're loved and cared for. And I think that CMHA has proved that it's really a truly integrated part of the community and out there to make a difference.
I spend a lot of time working directly with Ray Gorman, who's a wonderful leader for this organization, has taken it to a whole nother level. He's been a great partner for me in the work that Demas does. I want to congratulate him and the organization on 40 great years. I doubt that Ray and I will be around for the next 40, but we'll be around for a while together. And I look forward to the continuing partnership between the State of Connecticut, Department of Mental Health and Addiction Services, and CMHA for the benefit of our clients.
Do the hustle! Do the hustle!